Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about what is spontaneous reaction and how the energy is being dependent to describe whether the reaction is spontaneous or not. So now related to that, now we are going to talk about a new topic, that is nothing but the spontaneity itself, that is nothing known as entropy. So let us talk about that. So now let us talk about what is entropy actually. So the property of a system which measures the degree of disorder or randomness in the system is called as entropy. So it means if the degree of order means the thing, if since we know that solid, liquid and gas, these are the three matters, and in that we got to know that the solid are the substances which are present in more order, or they are present in a more orderly manner than that of the liquid as well as than that of the gas. So this indicates that if a substance or if a system is more order, then that will have less entropy. So for based on that, we have we'll discuss on few things. For example, now we are going to describe about the degree of disorder. So the degree of disorder will let us to understand that which system will have more entropy than that of the other. So we have this as an example. As you could see, I have drawn three diagrams in this case so as to describe a solid, liquid and gas, in which you could see that the solid has been more orderly arranged than that of the liquid, than that of the gas. So since this is morely order, since this is more order, so therefore the entropy of this would be very much less. So therefore this is a substance which will have less entropy. While that of the liquid are being dissociated with each other, or they have a huge difference between each other than compared to that of the solids, which have more intermolecular force of attraction. So since in this case, the molecules are being far apart, not far apart that much like gas, but yes, they are being far apart than that of the solid. So because the disorder is more in this case, more than that of the solid. So therefore, in this case, that is for liquid, the entropy will be the intermediate between the solid and the gas. So now when we are talking about the gaseous substance, so in this case the particles are being present to each other to a far distance, and this makes the substance to be morely disordered. And since entropy is related to the disorder of a particular substance, so therefore this is something which will have the most entropy. And talking about the entropy, because it is related to the randomness, or we could say it as the disorder of the particular substance. So therefore, this entropy is been denoted by the symbol S. So this is denoted by the symbol S. And talking about the next thing. The liquid is now have a entropy which is between the solid and the gas. So now we could easily say that the solid has the more randomness to move their particle afar from each other, and that makes the gaseous substance to have maximum entropy. So now let us move on further. So we have that the entropy change of a system in a process is equals to the amount of heat transferred to it. So in a reversible manner, divided by the temperature at which the transfer takes place. So it has a definition which has been related to the heat and temperature. And it indicates that the entropy change of the system, that is delta S. The delta S is nothing but the change in entropy in a process is equals to the amount of heat transfer. So that the amount of heat that has been transferred to a particular system so as to increase the entropy of that system, but in a reversible manner. The heat that we should transfer, that should be in a reversible manner, divided by the temperature at which the transfer takes place. So it depends on the temperature as well as it depends on the heat also. Suppose if a system like solid, if it is more arranged, means it has been arranged in a very orderly manner. So suppose if we have to increase the entropy of the solid, so what we are going to do is we are providing heat. So if we provide heat, then the molecules that are being associated with each other in an orderly manner, they will dissociate and they will form less order, or we could say they will form more disorder. So this will increase the entropy of the solid when it has been converted into liquid state, or when the process where the particles are being far apart from each other, that makes the system to be morely disordered. So it depends on the heat also, and the heat will be something which should be reversible, and on which temperature the entropy that takes place. So therefore the delta S is equals to Q reversible divided by. So this will play a very important role in solving a numerical. So now let us move to the next thing. So because of entropy, entropy is the thermodynamic property that determines the spontaneity of a process. That is what I have told earlier also. The spontaneity of a process means the process that takes place by its own, but it is related to that of the entropy. Because entropy is the thermodynamic property which will deal for a system, whether the system is been more spontaneous or not. So it determines the spontaneity of a process, and more the entropy, that means there are more chances of the system to be more spontaneous and to exhibit a spontaneous process or a spontaneous reaction. So it has been said that the higher the entropy of a system, more is the disorder of the system. So if the system has more entropy, then the system is basically morally disordered, and that will lead to a chance for being a spontaneous reaction or to form a spontaneous process. So for this we have for the reaction, since we have told talked about reaction also in spontaneous process. So in this case, when we are talking about entropy, so for reaction, the change in entropy, that is the delta S, is equals to the summation of the entropy of the product minus the summation of the entropy of the reactant. And if we want that the entropy of the that the change in entropy that we are known as, that is known as delta S, if that should be positive, then it should be clearly understood that the summation of entropy of the product should be more than that of the summation of the entropy of the reactant. That means that more the disorder of the product compared to that of the reactant, then there are more chances of the system to exhibit maximum entropy. So talking about this, we also have something which is related to entropy, that is the change in entropy, that is the total change in entropy. It will be equals to the change in entropy of the system plus the change in entropy of the surroundings. So this clearly indicates that the entropy always increases. The entropy of the universe, or we could say that the change in entropy of the total will be equals to the change in entropy of the system as well as change in the entropy of the surroundings. And it will always be positive because it will go on increasing. So talking about the next thing, if the change occurs from an order state to less order state, then the change in the entropy is positive. So this is what they are talking about. Suppose if I have dissolved or I have converted I2, that is iodine molecules that has been present in solid, and by providing particular heat or by increasing the temperature, suppose if I have managed to convert the solid iodine to liquid iodine or aqueous iodine, if you would say. So the thing that we have did is we have converted this ordered substance into disordered substance. So since entropy is known for its disorder, so because I have converted the order state into a disorder state, so now in this case the delta S will be said to be positive, because the final product is more disorder than that of the reactant, or if you would say than compared to that of the initial one. So it has been the initial state was less disorder, or we could say it was more order, and because of which the delta S was found to be positive. And recently we have did a formula here also, so as to understand that what is the change in entropy. So this will make the entropy to be positive. That indicates that it will have more spontaneity. And talking about the another one, suppose in this case, as you could see, that H2, which is a gas molecule, while oxygen is also a gas molecule, and when they both combine with each other, they will form water molecule, which is in a liquid state. So in this case, what happens is these two are basically more disordered. So I would write it as disordered. And now they are being changing into a liquid. So the gas has been changing into liquid, or basically we could say as the condensation takes place, in this case it becomes more ordered than compared to that of the earlier one. So in that case, because of which the product that we have obtained here is more ordered, so it, the entropy of this would be less than that of the reactant, which will ultimately make the change in entropy to be negative. So this is what entropy means, and it has a relation with that of the spontaneity of a reaction also. But it is not necessary that the spontaneity of a reaction will be equal to that of the entropy. Made a disordered system into an ordered system. So in this case, what we have did is we have converted a disordered system into an ordered system. That means the entropy will be less. But this change in entropy, that means if the change in entropy, suppose if it is positive or suppose if it is negative, so it doesn't clearly indicate that whether the reaction is being spontaneous or not. So therefore the entropy is not only the criteria to describe whether the reaction is spontaneous or not, but there are also some different criteria that would describe whether the reaction is spontaneous or not. But this this gives a overall glimpse when we see that the delta S is positive. So mostly we consider that the reaction or the process would be spontaneous. So this was related to the spontaneity, or it was related to the entropy. And talking about the entropy, there are few cases where the entropy is said to be positive. And that is when we talk about dissolution of NaCl water. So since NaCl is basically solid, so when it has been dissolved in water, so in that case basically what happens is the orderly arranged NaCl is now being dissociated in water, so as to become a less order, and hence the delta S is positive. But when we are talking about condensation process, in which the gas has been converted into liquid, in this the less ordered, or we could say the more disorder, is now been converted into an order state, and hence the entropy is now negative. Similarly, if we convert a metal, that is, which has been solid and now we have converted into a liquid metal, or by melting it, so therefore we have increased the entropy of that particular substance or of that particular metal. So this is what the entropy is, very much easy to understand. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very much clearly, and share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.